Hi guys, today we will see how to install MongoDB on Linux operating system. We have gone through the theory of this session earlier, but today we will see the practical implementation. So the first thing is that we have to download the MongoDB software. Let's download it. The software MongoDB can be downloaded from mongodb.org site. And there you will be getting an option to download MongoDB. Just click on it. You will get the tab for the options for the different operating system. So in our example, it is a Linux operating system. So select the Linux tab. There you can get the version of the versions suitable for the different versions. So here I'll select RHEL 5 Linux 64 bit. And then now click on the download tab. So the once the software is downloaded, we have to copy the software to the Linux machine. So I'm just clicking on the download and then I'll be copying the files to the Linux machine. Okay, I have downloaded the software and copied the software to my server. My server name is whitesith11gr52. I have copied to the whitesith folder. So ls-lmong. You can see that the software is there. Now we can untar the software. For that, I'll give tar hyphen zxvf space mongodb.gz. So you can see that it has the file is being unzipped and untarred and unzipped, and you can see that a folder MongoDB Linux x86 RHEL 5307 is created. ls-l. So a folder with the name of the file is created, and if you are giving ls-l, you can see that the file is all the files are extracted here. Now to make our configuration symbol, we'll rename this folder to MongoDB folder. Move MongoDB the original file space the MongoDB is a folder name. Okay, now go to this folder. And if you want the path variable to be set, you can set the path variable like export path equal to $path:\whitesith\mongodb\bin. Okay, now if you are seeing which MongoD is executable, the server executable. So if you're seeing, you can see that MongoD is there. Now the next step is that we have to have the MongoDB while starting, it expects a database directory. The default database directory is /data/db for all the Linux operating systems. So we must create this directory before starting the MongoDB server, or else you can, if you wanted to have a different directory, DB directory, that's also possible. So we'll see the first execution as starting the MongoDB using the default DB directory. So let's execute the MongoDB, let's create the directory mkdir-p. /data/db. Now I'll issue the command mongod. Okay, so here you can see that it has started a journal at the directory /data/db/journal, and journal files are just equal like our redo log files in the case of Oracle. And you can see that it gives a warning that the process is started as root, which is not recommended. Since it's a lab environment, that's fine, but in case of the production, I would recommend that you create a separate user and start up the MongoDB from that user. And also you can see that the process ID is 4528, and most important, the port number is 27017, where in which say MongoDB will be, that is the port number 2017 is the listener port for the MongoDB. So all the user connections are accepted through this particular port number. So we have, in this third line, we are getting all the sufficient information stating that MongoDB is starting with the process number 4528 on the port number 27017 with the DB path slash data slash DB on the host versus 11JR52. And you can see that here general writer is started, that is writing the log information. And now on the last, you can see that it is waiting for the connections on the port number 27017. Here MongoDB is started as a foreground process, so we can stop the MongoDB by giving a control C. And here you can see that it is going to shut down and going to close the listening sockets, and the shutdown is completed. Now, as I explained earlier, we can create and we can start up the MongoDB from a non-default DB directory. To do that, let's create a directory, mkdir slash voicethread slash MongoDB data, and we'll start up the MongoDB, MongoDB hyphen DB path slash voicethread MongoDB data. It's MongoD, type is there. Here also you can see that it is doing the same thing as the previous example. It is checking, it is creating a journal directory and see any recoveries required, and it's starting the MongoDB process on the process port number 27017 with the default with the DB path as slash voicethread MongoDB data. So here the important thing is that we are specifying the non-default DB path with the DB directory with the keyword hyphen DB path. So that is the location where the databases for the MongoDB is going to get created. And you can see that it is waiting for the connections on the port number 27017. Now in the next session, we'll see how to connect it to the MongoDB and create the databases, use the databases, create the documents, etc. Hope this session is clear for you guys. Thank you. Thanks for watching this video, guys. Hope this video was useful for you. If you have any questions on this topic, please send a mail to me. My mail ID is trainer@voicethread.com. And please do subscribe to our YouTube channel. The link is given in the bottom of this window. We'll be releasing at least one video every week. And if you have any specific requirement, please send that requirement to trainer@voicethread.com. We are happy to work on your requirement, and we'll be posting the video at the earliest. Once again, thanks a lot.